let me catch you up on what's happening. Queen Jenna can't attend the summit because someone has accused her of conspiring with Scarlet. The hearing is the same day. Someone's lying, and we have to figure out who. Soon as we know, we can confront that person and get them to recant their statement. We need to talk to everyone, find clues to the truth, and build evidence to defend the Queen. Once we discover who among them is the mastermind, we'll take action. But be careful. These people are suspicious and sensitive. Say something too blunt or off-putting, and they'll clam up. If we're obviously undermining their plans, they'll have us escorted out of the party, and it will all have been for nothing.
Introducing a hero who needs no introduction, the Commander of the Pact, and accompanying the Casimir Mead.
Keep it together, Kaz. You can get through this. Be confident, like Jory.
Casimir, come over here. Don't look so glum.
Care for an hors d'oeuvre?
Hello, dear Casimir. Don't worry your little face over what the Herald's papers say. You'll always be noble in my eyes.
Countess Anise, that's direct and kind of you to say. I'm afraid I don't feel particularly noble.
Then we must do something about that. Nobility isn't in the blood, as so many believe. It's in your choices. Your return to grace is only a pardon away. If your talent for detecting lies is all you say it is, well, let's just say I'm confident we can convince the Queen your value overrides your father's misfortune.
I only hope to be of some small service, Countess. Oh dear. Okay. Let's start picking apart everything they say. One of these ministers is spreading lies about the Queen.
Don't misunderstand, Countess. I'm certainly grateful to you for purchasing my billet and putting me to work. I'm just not sure I understand the reasoning behind dragging me to this soiree of yours.
He was up ill all last night. I told him not to eat that fourth pie. But I thought for certain it was Minister Wee who attended court the day Scarlet was there. Are you sure?
So good to see you, Mr.
I'm rich, you know.
And then he asked me what pair I wanted. To suggest I couldn't afford both. Why, I should have slapped him on the spot.
Care for an hors d'oeuvre?
I can take that. Thank you.
Huh?
What is it?
Here, I can get you some more. I remember hearing afterward that Scarlet approached the Queen. No one paid any attention back then. Scarlet was a nobody until the Queen's Jubilee.
Stop right there. I don't care about your dog's
this
new haircut.
This shrimp bisque is fantastic. I need another bowl.
For in this crowd. I could lend my eyes and ears to your search. If there's nothing in particular you need me to do, would you mind if I help myself to some of your refreshments? Am I really so dull? Well, here's something interesting. Would you like to know how long a severed head remains conscious? I suppose not. Do let me know if you need me to do more than make debutantes and fops uncomfortable.
Order.
What can I do for you?
So good to see you, Minister.
You've convinced me. It looks like Minister Estelle is the one spreading this horrible rumor. Let's keep at it. If we're going to confront her, we'll need serious evidence to back us up.
I know for a fact the Queen had a private talk with Scarlet. How? Everyone is saying it, so it must be true.
And you are...
I can take that. Thank you.
good observation. I had a feeling she was lying. The Queen wouldn't hold a private meeting with just anyone, much less a Silvari with no political connections. This woman will testify.
You must be mistaken. My niece knows a guard who heard from a doorman that the Queen... Oh,
may I take
I've said too much.
Corroborate the Queen's alibi.
Is lying a prerequisite for being in the ministry?
That's another witness who can help us prove the Queen's innocence. Nicely done.
I can take that. Thank you.
Looks like we've got everything we need. Time to expose Minister Estelle for the liar she is.
Gentlemen, please leave. I see you've been busy socializing with the guests.
Care for an hors d'oeuvre?
I can take that. Thank you.
So perhaps I misspoke. Apologies. I shall revise my statement.
An hors d'oeuvre?
Aren't you the nosy one? If you must know, I'll tell you what really happened.
I can take that.
Skip the small talk.
Oh, the audacity. Where are your manners?
Guards, please escort these scandal mongers to the gates.
Oh no. This isn't what was supposed to happen.
Skip the small talk.
I can take that. Thank you.
This way.
I think we're done here.
Stop. Don't approach her. It's an illusion.
Careful,
I am elsewhere. Find me, and we shall talk. My apologies for the deception, but I must go to unconventional lengths to protect Kryta.
Countess, Minister Estelle is claiming that you were there, at this secret meeting. She's implicating you.
Nonsense. I was at no such meeting. I did, however, receive a mysterious message signed only with the initial E. The note said that Estelle was in a bandit gambling parlor when she was supposedly spying on our queen. Reminding her of this will be enough to make her drop her lie, faster than Farron's dignity.
You're not planning another interrogation.
I can take
this
that.
This is a party, if you haven't noticed.
Nah.
I'll have you know I'm very well connected, and I...
Your connections can't help with this. We know what you've been up to.
What do you mean?
We know you couldn't have witnessed this supposed meeting with Scarlet. We hear you were busy meeting with some lobbyist that day.
Lobbyist? What are you talking about?
So much for subtlety. You were busy gambling with some ruffians.
Keep your voice down. That's a baseless accusation.
Is that so, Minister Estelle? Perhaps you and I should speak privately and sort this little mess out. Please follow my guards. I'll be with you shortly. Countess Anise, thank you for inviting us to your party. It's been an entertaining and productive evening.
No one is more delighted by your presence than I. With all that socializing and skullduggery, you must be craving the longest of naps. Now that this messy affair is out of the way, I feel fairly certain Queen Jenna will attend your summit. I think Minister Estelle will soon see the value in cooperating with me, rather than rotting in prison for treason. I may have use for her. On a separate note, I do hope you will stay and join the Queen's entourage, Casimir.
You mean travel with the Queen to the summit? I'd be honored.
Yes, I think that's the right play. You will, of course, have time to relay the full details of your father's story at that time.
Oh, I don't think the Queen would be interested in...
Nonsense. Now go. Say pretty things to my guests and enjoy yourselves for the rest of the evening.
Careful, Lord Earth. I can take that. Thank you.
It was nothing.
There you are, Countess. I trust I played my part in your charade this evening.
There, Blossom. You did very well as the sore green thumb at my affair. I'm sure everyone was far too intimidated by your glowering menace to notice it was an illusion standing beside you the whole time.
Yes, I thought you seemed rather vapid.
Really soon, but...
Time is just ahead. I'd go quickly, though. Those Asuran representatives are getting impatient.
My crewmates in Ratasum have been monitoring the Waypoint network. They say your device is affecting waypoints, not ley lines. Why?
Can't you see? I adjusted the settings in the waypoint so they process the flow of magic at a more stable rate. I'll put it in simple language for you. My device interfaces with the waypoints and captures on-the-spot readings of magic's rate of flow through them. Using a complicated algorithm that I devised, it calculates the exact minimum frequency required to keep the waypoint running. It then adjusts the waypoint settings.
Our readings are inconclusive without more information. We must demonstrate this device. Now. What are you whispering about over there?
We're formulating a plan to demonstrate how the device works. You'll note that this chamber has a number of waypoint-like props. We'll show you how it works. In miniature. You see, it's so easy, even a simpleton can do it. Take it away, Bram.
Uh-uh. You're not fooling me again. Hey, boss. Why don't you take this one?
There's an active waypoint. Well, a mini one. Go take control of the recalibration device. Great. Now take aim at the waypoint and fire away till its energy is gone.
Check your readings, bro. It is working. Keep at it. I want to see more.
Great. They're eating this up. Go get one more.
Truly impressive work for someone so young.
Whoa, that quake was not my fault. Not it, not it.
You're right. There's more headed our way.
Safe from harm.
Murphy's readings say that it's hiding under a tent. Look for one that isn't attacking back.
Yeah.
angry now. Watch out. He's about to attack.
Waypoints are protected. Wonderful.
So, will you agree to come to the Grove Summit?
Not so fast, my muscular friend. In light of this new development, I have decided to add further stipulations to the deal.
What? Are you...
Silence, Timey. As a ward of the College of Synergetics of Ratasum, you are required to hand over all inventions for study and documentation. I hereby claim proprietorship over this waypoint recalibration device. I will hold it in trust for you until your graduation.
No! I made this on my own time, outside of Ratasum.
Irrelevant. Hand it over like a good progeny, and we will see you at the summit.
No! I won't let you take it!
Tommy, no!
You wouldn't dare disobey your superiors, would you? Just hand it over.
Kid, come on! Calm down and think.
Told you! It's mine!
After that delinquent!
Tony! It is, she's headed deeper into the desert, and that means she's either in trouble now or will be very soon. Let's go.
A world of possibilities awaits.